Welcome to Wake Up with God. We live stream daily Mass today. We attend the Holy Mass on Wednesday, 12th June 2024. Wednesday of week 10 in ordinary time. Make me grasp the way of your precepts, and I will muse on your wonders. Please keep quiet and concentrate on attending the Mass.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who decreed that Saint Barnabas, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit, should be set apart to convert the nations, grant that the gospel of Christ, which he strenuously preached, may be faithfully proclaimed by word and by deed, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, a great number who believed turned to the Lord. The news about them reached the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to go to Antioch. When he arrived and saw the grace of God, he rejoiced and encouraged them all to remain faithful to the Lord in firmness of heart, for he was a good man, filled with the Holy Spirit and faith. And a large number of people was added to the Lord. Then he went to Tarsus to look for Saul, and when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. For a whole year they met with the church and taught a large number of people, and it was in Antioch that disciples were first called Christians. Now there were in the church at Antioch prophets and teachers: Barnabas, Simeon who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, who was a close friend of Herod the Tetrarch, and Saul. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul, for the work to which I have called them." Then, completing their fasting and prayer, they laid hands on them and sent them off. The word of the Lord. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm. The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise. Sing praise to the Lord with the harp and melodious song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Sing joyfully before the King, the Lord. let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt loses its taste, with what can it be seasoned? It is no longer good for anything, but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand, where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. I do believe that every Christian has two primary duties in life. First, we must strive for personal holiness. Second, we must work to help others to achieve the same degree of holiness. And brothers and sisters, this is what it means to be the salt and the salt of the earth and the light of the world. Brethren, consider salt. We all know that salt is a preservative and it also adds flavor to food. It does so by entering the food and in a sense, disappearing. Ganun din sa buhay pananampalataya natin. First, our Lord must enter our lives and preserve us from the corruption of sin. But as He does so, He will also bring out our goodness in a way that the flavor of holiness is evident to others. In this way, we will be used as salt for others. This is specially done by our works of charity. So be charitable. Light. Brothers and sisters, let us also consider light. The world in which we live is oftentimes quite dark and despairing. Parang nakakapagod. There is corruption all around us and temptations present in many forms. Depende kung anong estado tayo ngayon. Temptations knows his best para i-deform tayo. But the light of Christ must be made manifest far and wide. Dapat makita at maramdaman ng lahat ang masaya nating paglalakbay patungo sa kabanalan. And this is possible if we first work to become light itself, kung tayo ay liwanag na mismo. Christ, the true light of the world, must so permeate our lives that we find it almost automatic to shine brightly in a fallen world. When Christ is alive in us, we will radiate joy and peace, calm and conviction, moral goodness and determination. Ang sarap pong pakinggan. If we have Christ, ang gawa, our deeds, our words, ang ating salita ay dapat kawangis ng kay Kristo in our lives. And when we live this way, we will not help to impose the gospel on others. Rather, God's light will simply shine and be a beacon of hope to those who come into our presence. Yung hindi ka, if you have been the salt and light of the world, hindi tayo iniiwasan ng tao. Bagkus minamahal. Today, as we celebrate the feast of Saint Barnabas, a holy person who traveled, preached, baptized, celebrated the sacraments, and founded many Christian communities in his time. His dedication must have been preserved, enlightened by Christ in his ministry. He endured rejection, hardships, violence, and martyrdom, but he did not stop doing what is right and holy. His fervor stemmed from knowing his Lord, not only through his firsthand witness of Jesus' ministry, but also through his life of prayer and his perception of the Holy Spirit. Brothers and sisters, try to see his mission as one similar to ours. We too are called to zealously preach the gospel to others. Do not hesitate to do so, no matter the cost is. Pray that God uses you as he wills and offer yourself to his service in imitation of this holy apostle. Brothers and sisters, today we are called to be salt and light of the world. Saint Barnabas,
pray for us.
Saint John Bosco,
pray for us.
Jesus, King of Mercy, have mercy
on us.
Let us pray to God the Father, who wants all persons to be saved and to come to the knowledge of truth. Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. That the Holy Spirit may guide the Pope, the bishops, and priests in promoting the cause of the mission. Let us pray to the Lord. That missionaries may proclaim Christ to the world, not by power or prestige, but by humble service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That love of God and neighbor may inspire the lay faithful to collaborate in the missionary task of the church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christians may realize their responsibility of spreading the good news of salvation to all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That young men and women may have the courage to answer the call of Christ and to serve in the missionary apostolate. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Father, it is your will that your kingdom be proclaimed and established everywhere. Through the intercession of Saint Barnabas, grant faithfulness and fruitfulness to our missionary endeavor. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Sanctify with your blessing, we pray, O Lord, the offerings presented here, so that by your grace they may set us on fire with the flame of your love, by which Saint Barnabas brought the light of the gospel to the nations, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glories without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint John Bosco, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coursed to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ has said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Let us pray. As we celebrate, as we receive the pledge of eternal life, we humbly implore you, O Lord, that what we celebrate in sacramental signs on the memorial of the blessed Apostle Barnabas, we may one day behold unveiled through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Sa Don Bosco, masaya.
Sama-sama.
Thank you. Cảm ơn các bạn đã xem video. Nếu thấy hay, hãy nhấn like, đăng ký kênh và comment để ủng hộ chúng mình nhé.